At 16 years I was blue and sad. Then father said I should find a lad. So I set out to become a wife and found the real love of my life. His name, it was Chris, and the last was McGill. I met him one night picking flowers on the hill. He had lots of charm and a certain kind of touch and a certain kind of eagerness that pleased me very much. So there, 'neath the moon where romance often springs, I gave him my heart and a few other things. I don't know how long that I stayed upon the hill, but the moon had disappeared and so had Christopher McGill. So I went home and I thought I'd die, till father said, make another try. So out I went to become a wife and found the real love of my life. He came from the lowlands, said he. I saw him and knew he was perfect for me. Just one thing that puzzled me, and it always will, was he told me that he heard about me from his friend McGill. We quick fell in love and went down by the creek. The next day he said he'd be back in a week. And I thought he would, for now how was I to know that of all the lowland laddies there was never one as low. I told my father the awful truth. He said, what difference you've got your youth. So out I went mad to be a wife and found the real love. He was a poet, a rhymer was he. He read me some verse he had written for me. He said they would move me, these poems from his pen. And all right he was, because they moved me right into the glen. We stayed till the dawn came and lighted the sky. Then I shook his hand and I bid him goodbye. I never went back, for what I had heard was true, that a poet only writes about the things he cannot do. My pa said, look out for men who think. You'll be more certain with men who drink. So out I went to become a wife and found the real love of my life. Oh, he was a soldier, a fine Highland son. He told me about all the battles he'd won. He wasted his time telling me about his might, for one look at him decided me to not put up a fight. We skirmished for hours that night in the glen, and I found the sword has more might than the pen. But when I was drowsing, I snored to my dismay, and he thought it was a bugle and got up and marched away. Now Pa said, daughter, there must be one, someone who's true or too old to run. So I'm still looking to be a wife and find the reason.